Nylander has a look around. Wanted to go to the point for CeCe. Took it away from Hughes. Nylander stays on the puck. Goes to the net and a roll out the stick. Scores! Kapanen puts it by Blackwood. And the Leafs win it in overtime. 5-4. And I think the Devils put this one in their own net.
And Nylander initially, Hughes stripped the puck from Nylander. And then Jack didn't get it out. And Nylander took it back.
You're crazy the way he was able to steal it back. Now he'll take it to the net. And then Severson just throws it into the net. And an awful tough play for Severson. And again, a wonderful play by Nylander to steal the puck, bring it to the net. And then that caused the goal.
Anderson in the neighborhood. As we approach.
Oh,
this replay, good pressure, bad giveaway by Douglas Murray. He gets his signal crossed with Dan Boyle, and this puck looks as though it goes off Dan Boyle. This is reminiscent of the Steve Smith goal against for the Edmonton Oilers on Grand Fury in the playoffs.
It's an own goal.
It's an own goal, very similar, and it went in on the same side.
Catching the Nabokov by surprise. And he has seen flukes like this in every game of this series.
And the Sharks have to wonder, what else could they possibly do? They've played as great a road playoff game as you could possibly play here tonight.
On April 30th, 1986, the Edmonton Oilers, chasing their third straight Stanley Cup, were upset by the provincial rival Calgary Flames in Game 7 of the Smythe Division Final. Tied at 2-2 in the third period, Calgary took the lead in a most unusual way.
Things happen. It's an honest mistake that he would love to have back, but, you know, it's part of sports.
Celebrating his 23rd birthday, Oilers rookie Steve Smith's errant pass gave the Flames a lead they would not relinquish as they eliminated the defending champs.
To win a game like that, I mean, we were happy about it, but, you know, you kind of had the feel for Steve.
As tough as the loss was for us, it was incredible to see the growth of a player and a person in Steve Smith and to accept what had happened and deal with it and move on from it, only to come back the next year and win the Stanley Cup and be handed the Stanley Cup from Wayne. Talk about coming full circle, and in my mind is one of the most beautiful things in sports is that how it shapes us not only as hockey players but also as people, and that was a classic example.
Lucic has got an empty net. He gives it to Nugent Hopkins. Now Riddick is back in there. And whoa, they score! They get a bounce in front. It was centered off a leg and in.
And that's a bounce the Oilers needed to go their way the other night. They saw a tough one go against Chris Russell, and tonight it's just a tough one on TJ Brody. And the Oilers come up the middle of the ice, a nice rush, and you can see TJ Brody right in the middle, and he has Lucic. Instead, he might just want Riddick to take that puck, as I don't think Lucic would have reached this. And it goes right off his stick, right past Riddick, who had just made an unbelievable save on Connor McDavid.
So Brody over on that Flames bench, feeling the way that Chris Russell did a couple of nights ago in Edmonton.
Through the middle for Marlowe. Marlowe stops. Juice stopped by Bossois. Another chance. They score. Nazem Kadri with 1:05 left to go. Kadri's 13th goal of the season.
Chris Russell's played a heck of a game, and this is just bad luck sometimes. You just can't react fast enough. There's the shot. Chris Russell looks like he has it. The puck took up, jumps off of the stick. He turns and fires, and Chris Russell scores on his own net. Turns, tries to clear the puck. He turns and shoots, and he puts it by Laurent Brossoit. That's just a tough, tough goal. And Chris, who's played such a great game and tied the game up late, feels horrible.
Carry on by Tanev. Lafferty moving up with it. Tanev turns to the outside. Tanev fed one up.
I believe it was Gabe Landeskog that ended up coming all the way back, and I think actually puts this puck into the back of the net. He tried to take it out of the blue paint. The puck was spinning. It was on edge. And the puck ends up into the back of the net, and the Penguins win their fourth straight here in overtime. I mean, you're Landeskog, you see that puck. It hits your stick and then it starts spinning towards the goal line. I mean, you're in desperation mode to just try to keep it away from the goal line. And Tanev rewarded there, Doc, with the game-winning goal. He had a fabulous hockey game here.
And that one would go! Played along Gonchar, to the back to Hal Gill. Dealt wide of Crosby, hooked in front, paddled away.
Well, Sidney Crosby missed a wide open net. Hal Gill fires his puck. I think it was a pass, but it was too hot to handle. The one-handed pass. And is that Nicholas Backstrom that puts
scores into
net?
His own net? And Nicholas Backstrom put that puck in his own net. 19 in red.
UA passed it right to Backstrom. I think he was just trying to clear it. And Dupuis, at the last second, was sticking his stick into there. And Backstrom puts it in behind his own goaltender. But Crosby will get credited with this goal. The one-handed pass.
Pezzik gaining the line. He takes a shot. Rebound! He shipped it up in the air. It's right to goal crease. Where's the puck? Is it in the net? The Sabres think it's in the net. The goaltender's in the net. And Mike Smith is cheating like crazy. He's trying to move his knees to move it out of there.
Watch this. Watch this. The puck's going to drop right here. Hansel tries for it. It falls right in the back of his pants.
Lord.
And watch this.
Oh,
it's laying in his pants, and he's going to take it right there, right into the net. You can see the puck laying on the top of his pants, on his jersey, in the net. This is going to be a good goal. You see it right there. You can see the puck right there. See it?
Yeah, I see it, but I've never seen anything like this before.
It's Christmas. Ever. It's Christmas.
Well, it's Christmas for one team. It's bah humbug for the other one.
The play is under review.
Yeah, I'll bet it's under review.
Review of the play. The puck did cross the line. We have a good goal.